The internet can be a hostile public space, more so for women. But when comedian and creative writer Supriya Joshi was fat-shamed on Twitter, she decided to act. She tweeted fast and furious to silence those who sit behind the safety of their desktop screens and pass judgments on how women should ideally look and carry themselves.
Ever since I was a kid, I was body shamed. Back then, I wouldn't think we would call it body shaming, it's just bullying. Right from 5th to the 10th grade, there was this one guy and his daily schedule was he'd come into class and see how do I make Supriya miserable today.
Boys are wired a little differently than girls are wired. Now, in this wiring, knowingly, unknowingly, there can end up being a power play between the two sexes.
My sense of self was so low that I'm not capable of doing good things, or I'm good enough to do good things, because essentially my entire life I have been told, hey, you're worthless because of the way you look.
Looks matter for girls a lot more than they matter for boys. I've seen a lot of girls not ready to step out even for maybe going and buying something from a grocery store without makeup on.
Why do women feel the need to conform to society's perception of them in public spaces?
In an ideal world, I would like to say, of course, it doesn't matter, but it matters. Especially, this is the industry where looks be before everything else.
Supriya discovered herself strangely at the same school where she was bullied.
It was only when I reached the 10th grade that my music teacher, she thought, wow, like, you are a good singer. Why didn't you ever want to participate in the choir groups and stuff? Because I couldn't. If I did, this guy would make fun of me. That's the beating my emotional state took, that I started to believe everything, that I am, because I'm fat, I am not good enough to do all these things. I started watching this reality show. It's called RuPaul's Drag Race. RuPaul in the show says, if you can't love yourself, then how are you gonna love somebody else? And I was like, wow, this is it. This is just changed how I saw myself.
Supriya says her funny and dysfunctional yet functional family gave her space to find her voice, not just for music, but for her space in public life. But this did not end Supriya being trolled on social media.
Especially if you're a woman, society will tell, no matter what you look like or no matter what is your background, no matter what you do, society will try to push you down and, you know, essentially put you back into the kitchen. Don't listen to anybody, just listen to yourself. And know that you're worth so much more than what you give yourself credit for.
Sisters, high five, sister, yeah!